I've only got one escape. Do I want to use it? Let me think. No, I'm going to hold on to it. Because this place is really small. I mean, the exit's just right here. Mini demons! Not that much to them. I will tell you this, the first time I played this game, I freaked out when I saw those guys. I was like, oh no, oh no, it's those guys again. They've come back. Because remember, like, when I first played this game, I was stuck on that Demon Lord boss battle for, like, a week. And then I was stuck another 2 or 3 days on the Goblin battle after that. Then I was stuck on the next boss battle we gotta fight for another few days as well. Alright, mini demons. Let's see. Let's kill that. Let's kill a mini demon, and let's kill the nuke. And I think regular attacks should be enough to finish this guy off. And he dropped a potion. How generous of him. Alright. Let's give them their blood money so we can go and get our 400 gold. Almost said dollars. They don't use dollars. These gold pieces, because this is a medieval setting. You, give me my money. Yes. Okay, you. See the man? She's like, you don't even know. You don't even know where Artea is. She's like, she's gonna send us to another person. Oh, he was Artea's apprentice. Does that mean this man in the Northwest Tower is an elf? Like, he has to be some kind of elf. He can't just be a human because, well, you'll see when we get to Artea. But before we go to that castle, I want to do a little sequence break. Screw it. We'll just walk through. Actually, no. I'm going to go stay in the inn because I am almost out of nips. Keys. The bats are weak to water. I think I mentioned this before. Right over here. Let's get in the inn. The inn here is actually really expensive compared to this point in the game. Like, we go from, like, 20 gold? Yeah, so the inn in Chatham was 5 gold. The inn in Trek? Man, whatever. The inn in Trek was 10 gold, and the inn in Lufia was 20 gold. Now we got like 40 gold. It's like, what? So we're gonna kill these two kobolds. I'm gonna hit these rats with this dew. Don't expect to kill them, but it'll soften them up so that once we get the kobolds out of the way, we can just do this. Probably didn't even need to use the dew spell, now that I think about it. Well, anyway. Not that big a deal. Alright. So, the Northwest Tower is up here. There's like a peninsula at the end over there. That's where it is. And we're going to walk right by it. But we're not going to go into it just yet. Let's see. What do I want to do? We want to kill... Ruzard, a rat, and I'm going to flash the crab. You cheeky bastard. That's okay, though. The rats are not dangerous at all. I mean, they can call as many as they want. It just prolongs the battle like another round. It's not that big a deal. I want the experience. Let's see. Flash. Yeah, these guys are strong against water, so don't use it on them. Just take a sip of orange juice. Straight out the jug. It flashed on. Flash, you know, you may not believe this, but flash is actually useful way into like the 60 or 70% point of the game, because there are enemies. And we're gonna run into some of them soon, I think. Basically, I guess you could call them fighter-type enemies. You know, usually it's, basically, the way to describe it is men wearing armor. They're all weak. Thunder. And thunder does just a so... Like, the thunder spells do so much damage to them that flash will actually one-shot a great number of them, even after you learn the next tier of, you know, spell, which I think is bolt. So, goblins. Thankfully, these goblins are not nearly as sturdy as their boss counterparts. They do have a decent amount of hit points at this point in the game, don't get me wrong, and they do hit kind of hard, but they can be one-shot, so, by a ghoul. I don't think my hero has quite enough attack power to do it. So, alright. Zombies. We want to kill that red magi as soon as possible. These guys can do... They can cast Spark on your entire party, and it hurts a lot. Zombies, they just hit relatively hard, and they have a lot of hit points. Didn't I put a girl... Oh, right. They messed my party thing up when I got into that room. Rights. Now, if you're gonna make this run, keep your hit points up maxed after every battle, or as close as you can. I'm not too worried about a Guru. I do want to go to the shrine here. This is the second one of those shrines that I was talking about. We can go over here and talk to the old man, get an MP refill. Alright. So that was a good little refill. Not that we really needed it, but, you know, whatever. These are the enemies I was talking about. Like, these are the first. They don't all look like this, but basically anytime you have, like, a soldier-type enemy or anyone wearing any kind of heavy armor on their sprites, it's a good chance that they are weak to any of the lightning enemies. Now, these fights, they're called fights. I'm assuming that's short for fighter. But these guys, watch how much damage they take from fire. Yeah. They take quite a bit. And it will one shot. Oh my goodness. Don't worry. It's okay. Should have put Lufia in the back. That's my bad. Alright. Oh god. This is why I have these smoke balls. I didn't sell them. I don't think there's a church here. There's not even an item shop. So we'll come back. We'll loot this place. Yes. Let's see. Lufia's dead, but that's okay. I'll just use a sweet water, and if I get into a battle, I will... Just gotta run a short distance this way. And Smoke Ball. And flee. Come on, run, dang it. The run command actually in this game has a very decent chance of working, and it has the added benefit of you... There we go. You can always tell when the run works because everybody... I don't know if you noticed there, but Arguro actually went back as well. Please bring Lufia back to life. Yes, thank you. Sue. Alright. We want to buy... How much money do I have? I have 2,600 gold. Alright, so I want to buy a chainmail. I want to buy a wood shield. And I want to buy a wood helm. Plenty of money for that. Cool. Alright. I'm gonna put it all on my hero. Every bit of it. Alright. And I wanna buy. Two, so that's
6, 5, 10, 20, 25, 30, 6.
I need at least 6 minerals. So we'll go ahead and buy 4 plus 1. Alright. Now if you want, you can go ahead and buy like spears. And that's a pretty good like attack boost, especially for a guru. But I don't think it's required. I think the main reason to come in this way is to get the defense. Where's he in? 60 gold pieces, huh? That's okay. I've got a little extra money. Let me go ahead and some armor for a guru. You know what? No. If I have any extra thing, I need to buy a spear, I think. Since I'm here. Let's see what I got to sell. Sell that, and that, and that, and that. Can't sell that. Sell that, because you don't need it. You have a float spell. My magic could be useful. Miracles, by the way, sell for 2,500 gold. So if you want to sell those for some quick cash. I'll give this to him. Maybe he'll be able to one-shot some things he couldn't one-shot before. Alright, so we're set. Now we're going to use a swing wing. There we go. We've got two swing wings. Outside. I'm gonna go back to Grenoble. Go in and we're gonna save our game. Because this boss coming up is one of the hardest bosses in the game. Awesome. Yeah, all the boss difficulty in this game is front-loaded. Once you get to about the 50% mark, the bosses really are not nowhere near as hard. Alright. I need to put Lufia in the back row. I have to remember to do that. just as soon as this is over. Critical hit! Okay. And we learned a drain spell. What that does is it lowers your enemy's defense. It's very useful. Especially when you combine it with, like, power boards or the trick spell. Try to do spell with these guys. General rule of thumb is I like using like do and stuff on enemies. Groups of three. You bastard, that's my trick. Yeah, their flash spell doesn't do nearly as much damage as Lufia's, thankfully. Alright. Oh, 1 second.